military weapons.
Welcome back and thanks for checking out another video where today we look at the HWASONG-14, meaning the Mars 14. It's also known under the alternative US designation codename of KN-20 and is a mobile intercontinental ballistic missile developed by North Korea. It had its maiden flight on July the 4th of 2017, which coincided with United States Independence Day. North Korea is the only known operator of the missile at this time, and the missile has an estimated range in excess of 10,000 kilometers, making it capable of reaching most of the continental United States. The HWASONG-14 is likely a two-staged version of the HWASONG-12, first tested in May of 2017. The second stage appears to have increased its range, and the first stage engine appears very similar to that of the HWASONG-12. With a single liquid fuel engine, it has four veneer thrusters for stability and guidance. Michael Elliman of IISS and the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists both claim that available evidence clearly indicates that the engine is based on the Soviet RD-250, or the R-36 missile family of engines, and has been modified to operate as the boosting force for the HWASONG-12 and 14. According to his theory, an unknown number of these engines were probably acquired through illicit means operating in Russia and/or Ukraine. In August of 2017, the State Space Agency of Ukraine would claim that the rocket engine used during the July 28, 2017 missile test was an RD-250 made at a Ukrainian factory, but solely for use in the Tisklon space rockets that were supplied to Russia. The space agency chief said that according to Ukrainian information, Russia today has between 7 and 20 of the rockets, and they have these engines that have the documentation. They can also supply these engines from the finished rockets to whoever they want. The agency would then also claim that a total of 223 Tesla 2 and Tesla 3 rockets were supplied to Russia. Furthermore, they stated that North Korea cannot produce the fuel for the RD-250 and that it must have been produced either in China or in Russia. According to South Korean intelligence, North Korea has received 20 to 40 RD-251 engines from Russia in as recent as 2016. Preparations for a second test flight were detected by U.S. intelligence on July the 20th. Then on July 28th, the missile was fired at 11:41 p.m. local time, the first time in which a nighttime launch had been carried out. The missile would be fired at a lofted trajectory of about 3,700 kilometers, landing 998 kilometers away, with a total flight time of 47 minutes. Based on the data from the test flight, if the missile was actually fired at the optimal efficient trajectory, it's predicted that the maximum effective range would exceed 10,000 kilometers. If factoring in the rotation of the Earth, which may provide a range boost when traveling eastward, the HWASONG-14's coverage area would include the U.S. West Coast, Chicago, Illinois, and possibly even New York City, but only with a substantially reduced payload. Like the HWASONG-12, the 14 appears to be transported on an off-road capable Wanshan special vehicle known as the WS-51200, 8-axle transporter erector vehicle. This capability is particularly well-suited for North Korea, which has only around 700 kilometers of paved road throughout its entire country. The vehicle uses a U.S.-designed Cummins KTTA-19 C700 diesel engine, and the vehicle was imported from China, then declared for civilian use by the North Korean Foreign Ministry. Although it's hard to believe that the Chinese were not aware that North Korea would use the vehicle's chassis for its illicit missile program, available evidence would suggest that the Pyongyang did indeed add the erectors at facilities known to assemble missile transporter erector launchers. But the missile is launched from a detachable platform on a concrete pad. This could have several operational ramifications because it may increase the time that's required to launch the HWASONG-12 and limit the number of launch locations, pre-sited and pre-constructed launch pads. The Washington-based Institute for Science and International Security would estimate that last year, North Korea had 10 to 16 nuclear weapons at the end of 2014. This was based on an analysis done by the country's production of weapons-grade uranium and plutonium that was recovered from spent nuclear fuel. Revised estimates then led officials to believe that the country actually has four warheads, each of the weapons reportedly over 50% less explosive power than those that were deployed by the United States against Japan in World War II. Of its specifications, it has a length of 19.8 meters with a diameter of 1.85 meters. The launch weight at this time is unknown, and the payload is presumed to be HE or nuclear. Of its propulsion, it's a two-stage system that's liquid-fueled with a range of approximately 10,000 kilometers. It's in development, and its first service was seen on July 4th of 2017. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe and turn your notifications on for more like it in the future. Also, leave a comment and like it, and we'll see you next time.